Okay. As I said earlier, my name is Serena Champagne, and I'm currently dual enrolled at Florida State College of Jacksonville, taking a speech class online, and I'm planning on majoring in forensic psychology. But today, I'm going to talk about Les Parrott's book, 3 Seconds. The idea of 3 Seconds originated because studies have shown that it takes 3 seconds to redirect a negative thought in the brain. There are 6 negative thoughts that come naturally to us as humans. The first is to give up before trying. The second is the impulse to shun challenge, which is what I'm going to be focusing on today. The third is the impulse to settle for the status quo. The fourth is to shirk responsibility. The fifth is to do the bare minimum. And the fifth is to avoid taking action. Avery Rogers once said, "Half-heartedness and mediocrity never inspired anyone to do anything." There are 2 main reasons why people resist challenge. The first is because people believe that task is impossible. As humans, if we believe that something is impossible, then obviously we're not going to try and do it because we don't think we can. The second is it's just a lot of work to embrace a new challenge once you're set in doing the same routine every day. C.S. Lewis once said, "By perseverance, the snail reached the ark." In Berkeley, California, they did an experiment on an amoeba, and they put the amoeba in ideal temperature and living conditions, and so it didn't have to make any adjustments at all. But strangely, a few days later, the amoeba died. That's because God created us to want and need challenges in our lives. There are 5 reasons why you should embrace challenges. The first is that it takes you further in your life. Those with confidence are those who get noticed and promoted in their job. The second is that it increases your joy. Pearl Buck once said, "The secret of joy in work is contained in one word, excellence. To know how to do something well is to enjoy it." The third reason, is that it keeps you optimistic. If at first you don't succeed, try again. Obviously, when you feel like you can do something and you fail the first time, then it is a little bit discouraging, but if you know that you can do it, then you're going to be excited about it. The fourth reason is that it makes you tough. The Angola giraffe in Africa gives its birth to its babies from 10 feet above the ground. After the baby is birthed, then the first thing the baby tries to do is try and stand up. The mother will kick it until it stands up, and then once it stands up, she'll kick it back down again. The reason for this is she wants the baby to learn how to stand up on its own, and then once he stands up without wobbling, then she kicks him down just to help him remember how he stood up the first time. And as you can see, giraffes are some of the most graceful animals in the animal kingdom. And the last reason is that embracing a new challenge keeps you growing. Unless you try to do something beyond what you have already mastered, you will never grow. And that's what Ralph Waldo Emerson said. So I challenge you to challenge yourself.